South Asian parents in Canada are often on a hunt to find new and innovative ways to teach their kids about their homeland and its rich culture. Deeksha Pal Narayan is one such parent. When she was unable to find any books online that her son could culturally relate to, she decided to take matters into her own hands, literally.
When I looked around, all I could find were books from South Asia. And the South Asian books don't represent our North American children out here. They are wonderful books, no doubt about it, but they don't lead the lives that our Canadian children lead.
Narayan's first book, Ved and Friends Celebrate Dasaran Diwali, talks about all the events that led to why Diwali is celebrated and also captures how this festival is celebrated in North America.
It's divided into three sections. The first section is how North American children out here celebrate Diwali. We make it easy for parents that you don't have to do everything what has been taught to you. You can make up your own new traditions and do it yourself. The second part talks about the legends. Who is Durga? Who is Sri Ram? Who is Narkasur? And in the third section, we have all our DIYs. How to make a Ravan, how to make coconut laddus. Because it's very important that if we want to teach our children our festivals and our, you know, our heritage, we have to do it with them.
What started off as Narayan's attempt to introduce various South Asian cultures and traditions to her son has now become a series of four books catering to the South Asian diaspora across the globe.
I made a samosa stand in one of my stories, and how grandparents, you know, helped make a samosa stand and sell samosas, which is a very popular Indian, you know, snack out here. So normalizing South Asian things that we do and the relationship between grandparents and grandchildren was explored in No No Nana.
With a mission to make culture cool, this book series encourages children to add their own spin on old traditions.
My favorite activity during Diwali is all the crafts and listening to stories. We make ravens, we make ram hats and others like Diwali rocks.
Since all of us, most of us Canadians are immigrants, we might have come here 3 years ago or we might have come here like 50 years ago. We've all come here from somewhere else. So it's important for us to keep our heritage alive because that tells us who we are and where we come from and what our background or our history is.
For City News, I'm Nandika Ravi from Omni News.